We are going to discuss big IP virtual server curation. So today we will look how we create the virtual servers in F5 LTM. So before we continue with the practical, let's discuss some about virtual server. So virtual server components are node, service monitor, pool, and then we define the virtual server. So before defining the virtual server in the LTM, we have to first configure the node. So node are the backend servers for which the LTM will perform the load balancing. So these will be the servers for which the load balancing is performed. So first of all, we have to add a node. Node would be the backend service. Then we configure a service monitor. Service monitor is used to monitor the health of the nodes. So let's say if I have added a web server which is listening at port 80, so I'll configure a service monitor for port 80, which will continuously, you know, check the health of port 80 on that web server. If it is down, it will report to virtual server that the backend server is down. Then we define the pool. So pool consists of the nodes. So we add all the nodes which are for a particular purpose of in a pool. Then in the end, we create a virtual server. In virtual server, we call pool and service monitor. So this is our lab environment in which we are going to do the practical. So in our environment, we have two web servers. One is 192.168.31.6. Another one is 192.168.31.7. Both are listening at port 80. And this is our load balancer setup. Our load balancer IP is 192.168.27.2. We are having two VLANs. External VLAN is 192.168.11.0.0, is in subnet 192.168.110.0, and the internal VLAN is in subnet 192.168.31.0. And the IPs that we are using is the internal self IP is 192.168.31.2, and the external IP is 192.168.110.2. So today we are going to look how we configure the two ARM load balancer. So for two ARM load balancer, the request will be received on the external interface, and internal interface will be acting as a gateway for our backend servers. So let us continue now. So this is our load balancer. The management IP is 192.168.27.2. So let me first log into our load balancer. Now in order to create the LTM, in order to create a virtual server, we have to go to local traffic. Then first of all, we have to add the nodes. So I'll go to local traffic. I'll add the nodes. So in order to add the node, click on plus option. So my first node will be web server 1, and the IP is 192.168.31.5, and I'll just keep everything on default setting. Now again I'll add the another node. So again I'll hit plus button. This will be web server 2, and the IP will be 192.168.31.7.6. okay, I'll finish it. Now both the nodes are added, so I'll go to the pools and configure a pool. So in order to configure a pool, go to pool option and select plus option there. So the name of this pool will be web server pool. Here you have to select the health monitor. So health monitor will monitor the health of the backend server or the nodes, and it will report the health to the load balancer. So as we are using as our web servers are listening on HTTP, so we will be doing the monitoring on port 80 itself. And this is the load balancing method. So you have multiple options like round robin, least connection member, least connection node. So for now we will leave it as round robin, and we will add our nodes. So this is our first node, and service port will be 80 HTTP, and now this is our second node. So now we have configured our pool having these two web servers, and we have selected the service monitor for port 80. Now this web pool, if we check the status of this web pool, it is available because the monitor is up. If the servers are down and if they will not respond to the health monitor of HTTP, this will show us down, but as both the servers are up, it is showing us available. So next step is to configure the virtual server now. So we hit again plus here. So first in today class we are going to configure the two arm load balancer. So in case of two arm load balancer, the virtual server IP will be in the external VLAN subnet. So all the requests from the client will be received on the external VLAN subnet, that is the external interface, and the gateway for the virtual server will be the internal IP of our load balancer. So the gateway will be the internal IP of the load balancer, and the virtual server will be in the same subnet as of the external interface IP. So this is again web server load balancer. So we'll just write that this is 2-arm load balancer, and source address we will leave it as blank because it is for all the source. Now the IP would be the virtual server IP would be in the subnet of the external VLAN. So that is, we will take 192.168.110.4 service port. The web servers are listening on port 80, so it will be 80. Now here we have a option to define the source address translation. If you see here, see here we have the option to define the source address translation here. If you see this one, this will be used only if we are configuring the one arm load balancer, because in one arm load balancer the load balancer do the source address translation, but as we are configuring the two arm load balancer, this is not needed. So we will leave it as blank. Next we will configure the default pool, that will be our web server pool. Okay, as of now we are not defining any iRules, so it is done. So now our web server is configured and it is up. So let's try to access this IP. See, now when we try to access the virtual server IP, that is 192.168.110.4, I am connected to one of the web server. So some traffic will go to this web server and other traffic will go to the other web server. So this is how we configure the two arm load balancer. Thank you.